Hey, good afternoon, everybody. And welcome to the studio. Hey, everything works. Everything works. Now all we need is a cat. Let's see. Here we go. Now I've got everything up that I need to see. How's everybody doing today? I'm doing a little bit of throwing because I've got my Christmas orders like made up, mostly made up, and they are in the bisque right now, which I should go check on in a little bit. It's Friday! Yeah! It's Friday! It is Friday! Happy Friday! But Belzy, hello, how are you? You've only got 30 minutes left for your work day. Ooh, so close. And you are spending your time very wisely. You are. Whoop, I heard a cat. Multitasking. Do we have an empty bag for scraps? I am doing all right. I've got a bit of a sinus infection. But it's not hurting me too bad. I'm on day 3 of Mucinex. I need to measure this and see how big it is. I couldn't have done that if I tried just slinging a piece of clay on there. I have gotten my Christmas orders made up, all my last minute orders made up, and they are in the kiln. But we have a show the second weekend in January, so I need to make some stuff for that too. Okay. This one is a little bit on the taller side. Tomorrow is your last pottery class? Until you buy more, you'll be glazing some pieces. Nice. Speckled clay. That can have such a nice look. It can. What good does it do to set up my guide? What good at all? I'm gonna do it anyway. Here we go. Now I can see a little bit. Okay. All right, hold on. I'll get out of your way. He still got his bow tie on. He actually got it off, but I put it back on him. Here you go. Well, there's Mimi. Hey. So what do you think of your pottery class, Belzy? Are you going to do it again? Clean my hands off so I can pet the cat. You might wait when you have more money to pay for it, yeah. What type of things have you made? Good back scratch. Alright, you gotta pay the tolls. There we go. You could look up when your head is coming around to the camera instead of looking down. Ooh, there you go. Are we done? Okay. There you go. Oh, you do. You do have a wheel. You have a wheel at home, so you practice in when it's when it's warmer. Yes. Throwing a pot outside in the cold is no fun. I have done that before. Because when I was first starting out, I was in my garage, and I believe it was summertime. And then when the fall came in the winter, I did not throw for a bit. But when I tried to, I would get hot water from the sink and take it out there and throw for a little bit, but it was not fun at all. Oof. All the purrs. So handsome with your bow tie. I'm glad you kept it on. Minnie, like, killed hers. She did not appreciate the bow tie. And we saw her just kind of, like, flipping it around and playing with it once she finally got it off. Bryce on, Bryce off, and Cobalt Reaver, hello. Good afternoon. Come on now. Oh, gotcha. So instead of mild time, it was mean time. Gotcha. I thought you meant you would like you would throw when it was a milder weather. I put you over there so I could have my wheel back. And now you're here again. It's in the basement and it's heated, so it's all fine. Yes, perfect. Yep, go bother somebody else. Did you nearly fall? Was that not a very good 3-point turn? Lassa, hello. Good afternoon. Yeah, I think so, and then we can do handles after that. Lassa, you were on Facebook and noticed I was streaming, so that's better than a notification, right? That's the only thing I don't know about Restream is if it, like, if Twitch still sends out notifications. I don't know, did anybody get a Twitch notification? Twitch notifications are always kind of iffy anyway. Hey, Manny. More worried about Kiba. Meanie, meanie. Come on. Come on. Here we go. We're gonna have both of them in here. Have a cat. You had to go that way. You had to go that way. You couldn't go around the other way. Biggie, you did. You got a Twitch alert. Okay, good. Why she had to take that route if she was going over there, because she walked through all the stuff I've got on my table to come over there. Oh, there she is. Because she really wanted just to go over there. Minnie's starting to appreciate the bottled water as well. Craftsessive Studio, thank you for the follow. So this was a little bit tall. I'm gonna. What are you doing, buddy? Are you trying to get down? Thank you. Appreciate it. Thank you. You've been so helpful. You're not gonna like it, it's still wet. I think. Yeah, that's UPS. Come on. Give Kiba a hug. Then set him down. That's really the only way to move him. Otherwise, he flails. Is Minnie getting bigger, or is that her winter coat? She's a little bit fluffy, but she's also, you know, she's been enjoying her treats quite a bit. So it might not all be fluff. We've all had some extra treats since Thanksgiving, yep. No, Minnie's doing good. Although she did not like her bow. She did not appreciate that at all. Kiba didn't care. Belsie, you got a new kitten! Oh, tell us about it! You got a birthday party on Sunday, so the losing weight thing is on hold till after Christmas. It's so hard to do between Thanksgiving and Christmas. There's so many things going on. Belzy, we need to know the color and the name. Jelly bean. Black kitty. Now you have other black cats, don't you? Oh, it's Ib's birthday. Yeah, Belzy. Oh, yes. I love black cats, too. They are wonderful. We have one black cat still. Out of all of our herd. But I think we've consistently had a black cat, I think. Maybe for a bit after Vader we didn't, but she's a lot of energy. Yeah, a lot. You forget when you don't have a kitten for a while how much of a jumping bean they are, a jelly bean. Bouncing off the walls. Like ours, I think we've had him for we've had him for 2 years, so they're what, 2.5 years old, whatever. But they he's just now settled down to where he wants to cuddle, and still if there's a distraction, he's gonna jump up and go figure out what it is. But he's calmed down enough finally that he wants to cuddle. That one is not as tall as I thought it was. Let's fix that. So I'm making some more things right now because we have a show the second weekend in January. And that is coming up pretty fast. So we've got our Christmas orders processing. I wanted to go ahead and start making some more things to build our stock back up. So you've got a kitten and a 16-year-old. I think you told me that. And then, like, but are they getting along? One of your cats that is five still shakes the house with her zoomies. Ooh. Oh, Lassa, Em's gonna be 13. Oh. Looking back, it's such a hard age, but at the time, it doesn't seem like it. We have been painting our living room, so we've had plastic down, moved furniture out, so we've got stuff everywhere. And the cats have just been having a field day with the plastic sheeting that we put down and then paper to cover things up. It's like, oh yay, a new obstacle course. It rattles. It makes noise. And so they like run from one end of the house to the other doing rattling the plastic. And they haven't torn it up too much. We are to the point where tonight we're putting on a second coat and then it'll be done. And so far I've only had to clean off one cat's nose of paint, and I've had to clean off one cat's tail from paint. And that's it. We have managed to not have little kitty paint footprints all through the house, nor our own footprints. One of your cats is an elephant stomping down the hallway with zoomies. Yeah, some of ours make more of a thud than others. Oh, your cat, the older cat, is not impressed. But they cuddle plenty, he just doesn't want to play. Yeah. That's what Kiba and Minnie's relationship has turned into. Like, there was lots of hissing at first. Like, he did not want her anywhere near him. But he was not, like, chasing her away. That's the reason, like, we considered keeping her, besides the fact that she didn't have anywhere else to go, was that, like, Kiba wasn't super aggressive with her. But over time, she's worn him down so that they will sometimes cuddle. They are both very good cats. And they were both strays. Aw, that's probably good for both of them. She can learn how to be a cat from him, and he can have somebody to take care of. Alright, welcome back, everybody. Hey, Arm. Good afternoon. We are just getting started. Yeah, mudslinging pyromaniac, which is what I titled the stream. Has always been my favorite description of somebody who does pottery. It's like one of those memes. It's what I put on all those memes that says, "Explain your job badly." You've been studying for your certification test? Certification test. Oh, good. Yeah, sounds like you're ready. Afternoon. Thank you for the raid. Crystal Wolf. Do we have any snow yet? We do not. We do not say the S word around here. Hey, Paul. What were you doing today? And if any of y'all don't know Paul, which I'm sure all of you do know Paul, go check him out. He is Santa Claus for nerds. Makes pretty much anything you could ever want. If you can think of it, he can make it. See, we heard each other spiel like 15 million times while we were at TwitchCon together. You have a ton of snow? Whoa, it's snowing right now. You just got back from LA. You've been awake for 37 hours. What were you doing? Something super secret you can't talk about? That's amazing. I'm only a little bit jealous. Belzy, you need to practice getting your cylinders higher. You can't bring them as high as mine. Yep, practice, practice, practice. But I'll go over it again if you want. Are the corked potion bottles pretty airtight? They, you know what? I have not checked. I mean, it's a cork, and they're tight, but I don't know that how perfectly airtight they are. I just don't know. The corks fit tightly, but, you know. So this step, like, that I did, just kind of bringing all that clay up into the volcano shape, that's one that kind of combines a lot of those first steps where you, like, push the clay in and do your first little pull and gives it a little bit of height. That can sometimes be where a lot of people, like, you put too much pressure on the wrong spot and the whole ring just comes off. This one also, so one of the biggest things I see people doing when they're trying to pull up the wall, which is what it's called, is you think that you're doing a pinching motion like this, trying kind of pinching the clay and making it thinner, but it's not necessarily that, it's a stretching motion. So I push the clay out with my middle finger, get under it with my knuckle on my right hand, and then we stretch it up. So for this first one, I am pushing in on the bottom and getting underneath there, so I'm going to be pulling from here. And so pushing out and then lifting up a stretching motion. Here we go. And that gives it a bit more height. Right, Paul? Everybody wants things before Christmas. I've gotten my pieces produced, and they're in the kiln. These that I'm working on now are going to be for January. So you really like watching me do the steps, like in slow-mo, like I sometimes forget to do. A bit of a wobble, and when I get a wobble, instead of like trying to stretch this up again, I put my hand right above it and I use downward pressure, straight down, slowly going down, and that will sometimes fix it. Because what causes the wobble is my hands not being moving either faster or slower than the wheel, and that's what tends to cause or start a lot of wobbles. Sometimes it's also because that part of the clay might be too thin, but it's also because of what your hands are doing. Just watching is instructive. The repetition makes is a way to your subconsciousness. Crystal, you gotta get back to work. Well, thanks for stopping by. So this should be, if should it decide to be a mug today, this should be number 20. And it's all downhill from there. I don't know how many I'll get to today. But any is better than none. It's 20 ounce, the most popular size. Yes, it is. I don't know, like, how we would really test that. I mean, 20 ounces, when people are on the website, 20 ounces is the most popular size ordered, though we get a lot more variety from website orders because you can see everything there at once. Like, when we go to a show, everything's 20 ounce. That's just my standard size because it is best-selling, so I take all the 20 ounces and then not many of the other sizes because there's usually only so much room when you're in a 10 by 10 booth. So we've had... What am I doing? I was trying making a... Why am I making a travel mug? That's not what I need to make. I've seen a lot of tankards come through this year on order. Here we go. The mana potion mug is an interesting design. Yes, so the health, mana, and stamina are individual shapes, and I made those, I think I actually made those for TwitchCon the very first time when we went there as like a video game reference. But it can, you know, has a very wide gaming, it's not a specific video game reference. It's very generic, actually. But I made those as like, the closest I could get to like potion bottle shapes that could still be a mug. So I made those three shapes. And the, I think actually, so I did that before I started making tankards a lot. And people asked, like, wait, you do that? You just make it taller and make it a tankard. Make a tankard. And so I did. But it's actually a very traditional pottery design. There's something called a boating mug or a captain's mug. It's called both things. That's very wide and then has a, you know, relatively a narrow rim. But it's that way. It's very, the wide base is, so if you're on a boat and it's sloshing around, it's not going to fall over or spill. But I also thought it kind of looked like a beaker too. Belzy, have a good day. Banny, hello! Yay, someone from Kick! So we are multi-streaming. We're on Twitch and Kick and Facebook and everywhere else. Yeah. Not on TikTok. Not on TikTok. I don't even think... I don't know if I may have an account. I think I may have an account. I think I may have done one. So I'm making some mugs. These are not destined to be out by Christmas. These are going, this is stock going with us to a show. Yeah, Danny, that's why we're trying it out. It's time for me to get a new sponge. This one's getting kind of holy. Holy. Cheers, Steph. Hey, thank you for the raid. Welcome, everybody. Good afternoon. On the wheel today. Steph, we have some mugs. Your larger than average 20 ounce mugs. There we go. We've got our Christmas orders. Doing well in processing. Now I am working on a show that we've got in January. And then if any, you know, other orders come through, I'll try to process them real quickly. But right now I'm building up stock. And since mugs is mostly what we take to these shows, we'll be making mugs and then probably some tankards too, and then the potion bottles. It's a muggy afternoon. It's very muggy in here. It's getting there. It's getting there. Speaking of that, let me go look at the kiln. Be right back. Just gotta go to the other side of the wall. Through the looking glass. You want to collect all three health, mana, and stamina shapes? Yes! Can't stop at just one. And that's what we'll, when we take things to shows, we put together some gift sets, and that's the only way you can get the cork lids for the mugs is if you buy a packaged gift set. Because not all the corks are going to fit in all the mugs, so it's not something I offer like with every one of them. So when I do a big batch, I find ones that fit and make those into gift sets. Our next show is in New Orleans. New Orleans. Do I ever come to Washington State? I don't think I've ever been to Washington State. We have done shows out in California. I guess the closest we've been to you then is San Francisco, which is not close at all. Yes, you can have it, because I do not need it. We're here. There it is. Okay. Is nap time over, Mimi? Big yawn. let's move these and see how many I have. Though with all the people that are coming to the con we're going to, because it is, it's a convention, it's like a sci-fi pop culture convention that we're going to in January. It's called Fan Expo. Like, the guests they have there, they have several of the Lord of the Rings cast. So I feel like everything I throw today should just be, like, Prancing Pony mugs. Lord of the Rings mugs. That was 22. You mean Orlando Bloom? Ooh, that was my fingernail. Oh, I didn't know he lived around here. He probably doesn't. Yes, he's Legolas. Crystal Wolf? Yes, we're going to be at the one in New Orleans in January. That's what I'm making stuff for. Yeah, they have them all over. It's just like they run several shows. Or it seems what they do is they may buy out or and then like manage a local show and put them all under the same name. Salt Lake in Utah, yeah. So the ones I've been seeing a lot of ads for recently are there's one in Canada, which I'm assuming is in sometime close soon, maybe. And then New Orleans is in January. And then their big one, which is MegaCon in Orlando, is in May, I think, when everything else is. Standing on. Dark Sun, hello! Fellow Earthbender! Yes, we've been wearing my Earthbending shirt. You can't really see it. But. Like, if clay was a superpower, throwing clay was a superpower, what magical system would it be in? I thought earthbending. You crystal wolf. No, no, nothing should ever taste like cigarette smoke. Nothing ever. I would throw that away right now. Here we go. Yeah, earth, fire, water bending, all of it. Oh, Dark Sun, like there's the kineticist in Pathfinder. Never played Pathfinder, but like, yeah, there's so many magical systems that revolve around people using powers to manipulate the elements, and they all have different names for them. I mean, I do a lot of reading and mostly in fantasy, sci-fi stuff, and so. Yeah, whenever you have a magical system, you always see, oh, what would I relate to most? What would I be? Or you think about that. That's not what's supposed to happen. But so some water got underneath there. That was too thin. I'm gonna try to put it back. And see if I can make something with it. When I picked it up, I may have messed it up too much. Some of this clay down here. Mash that back down. I think we can work with it. May have to redo these side walls. There we go. A little bit uneven, but I think it'll still make a pot. Not going too terribly fast here. Let's just get back up to the point where we were. That's somewhat of a volcano shape. Go a little bit faster. And there's our weak spot. But we've got good height. That looks good. Heat Tender, the 20-ounce health potion. Just do pink. And leave me a note if you want it to be the white over pink, because that's like the only thing I ever use that for, is I make that it's just white, the white glaze dripped over the pink. So just choose pink and then let me know in the comment section that you want one like the picture, white over pink. Yeah, I don't even have a name for that color at all. I guess we could just call it health color, like we did with mana. Yeah, your brother plays D&D, so he'll love it. Yes. Crystal Wolf. You know what? I just recently realized that sodas had expiration dates. Because I'd never thought about them being around long enough to expire, but... Because if they sit in the back of a store for long enough, they can go flat. Or a warehouse. Needs to be taller. Did we have some problems there for a second? We need to slow this down a little bit. Why is this one wonky? Why this one? So there is only so many times you can like rework a piece on the wheel because you are adding water to it every time. So if two or three times it doesn't do what you want it to, it's probably going to collapse. Hey, Kesmond. Good afternoon. Yeah, and happy Friday, everybody. I keep forgetting that it's Friday. You're resting up as you... Oh, you had a nasty slip in the shower. Oh, no. I can imagine you're black and blue all over. Back is sore, I bet. But I hope you weren't hurt badly. Just a little bit sore. Oh, yeah. Landed on your rear end. Sure. I know, like, I slipped and fell in my driveway a couple of years ago, and I did that, like, I kind of twisted my knee a little bit and then landed right on my bottom. And, like, it was like, horrible. I couldn't, because I couldn't sit down, because it hurt to sit down. And it hurt to stand up, because my knee was hurting. And so, I was just miserable. Wonder Hamster, what is my favorite neon blue color? Neon blue? What would that be called besides neon blue?
Would it be blue-gray?
A grayish blue? So we painted our, we're painting our living room, and I chose something that I thought would be kind of a bluish gray, but it ends up like, once it's on the wall, it's very blue, which is going to stay that way. We're not doing it again. It's going to, but it's fine, but it's more blue than I thought it would be. Neon. Purple Daisy, yours is the color of an electric lemonade from a good bar. There you go. Like I said, I think we've done good with painting the wall so far. We have only had to remove paint from two cats. Out of five. We have a total of five. So. You are right. Yes. Well, it's been 15 years since we painted this room. We may not wait 15 years to paint it again, but had to count. You could see me counting, I'm sure. Can you pick up gray paint on the way home if that's what you want to do? Call the blue paint a primer. Kesman, you just got done painting your mom's room before she returns from India. Oh, that was sweet. Does she know about it? Or is it a surprise? Got the week off. What's up? Okay, let's look at it. Did it stop in the middle of running or okay? Be right back. We are back. Pugmill is working again. Well, Kesmond, aren't you productive? You did your gym workout this morning and then painted that room. Double shoulder workout. Yeah, we've got the walls painted. We need to do the baseboards and stuff. Give me a second, coat on the walls and then baseboards. So this one keeps getting wider and shorter. Let's make it a bit taller and skinnier. How about that? Did we get the order in? We got harmonicas. This one looks like a kidney. You know, sometimes they call it the kidney rib, or for the things this shape, kidney-shaped rib. But this is the metal rib. we have 34 mugs. Got a bit of a wobble there. we go. Well, I'm almost. Almost. Ooh, this feels wobbly already. Need to remember to slow down. Here, that one was better. We could do just more of these, more of the mug shapes, mug sizes. That ripped a hole in it. I don't know if that one's gonna make it. I may just scrap it. We have a claytality. So what happened is I'll use that clay on a batch for another day. We'll reuse it. Because clay, as long as it's not been fired, you can reuse it over and over again. So it takes a little bit of the pain out of losing something. I'm gonna stop and get a drink. I did not stretch. There we go, that does feel good. Do you hear that? I'm like, what in the world is so... How loud is it that we can hear somebody's car thumping in the back of the building with the pug mill on? Oh, yeah. Oh, definitely. Somebody's gonna be deaf by New Year's, yep. Oh, you sent me an image in Discord of how bad the weather is where you're at. Oh no, how bad is it? How many inches or feet is it? Do it. Good morning from Japan. Whoa, good morning. Happy Saturday. Or wait, is it Friday? I don't know. What day is it for you? Oh, it's only about an inch. Okay. But it's getting worse. Where, what part of the country are you at, Crystal Wolf? Japan is in the future. Well, welcome from whatever time zone you are in. And good afternoon, good morning. She just stuck with welcome. Utah, okay. So, do you get a lot of snow up there? I think you would. At least more than we do. We don't tend to get a lot of snow here. Like, it usually doesn't get, like, really cold. Consistently cold until January or February. It is Saturday. You are coming from the future. Whoa. Well, good morning. What do you have planned for your Saturday? And Cartoon Man, thank you for the resub. And good afternoon. Gotta go to work. Gotta make the donuts. Hey, Minnie. Oh yeah, where you are at, you get snow in the feet, not the inches. Yeah. We'll do it. Thank you for the follow. Yeah, you can keep that devil's dandruff up there. Well, today we are making it muggy in here. But without any frozen precipitation. Around here, we don't say the S word. Snow. For fear it might actually happen. Say that word down here and people make a panic run on the grocery store for French toast, right? Because you still got to eat good if you're snowed in. No, it's because it's the only thing we know to do. One health potion mug ordered. Yay! Thank you! I might actually have one. I'll have to check and see if you ordered it in the pink color. Move these two out of the way. You made sure, yeah, instead of milk and eggs, you got toilet paper and alcohol, yeah. Necessities. You say snow there and everybody's happy, not you. You actually are terrified of the frozen precipitation because you had a bad accident last year in the snow, yeah. Well, I imagine up there it has a lot to do, snow has a lot to do with tourism, too. Like, I remember the year we went out to Yellowstone, it was like in February, and it was unseasonably warm, so the snow was starting to melt, and they still had all of their, like, snowmobiling season left, and so they were having to cart in snow for some areas to keep it, you know, so the snowmobiles could pass on the road still. I think they were having some type of snowmobile competition, and so they had to have snow. Black ice is the scary stuff. Thank you. Oops. Stay with me now. There we go. Just make sure that's been repaired a little bit. Over 50, do we? We have 52. crystal wolf. Oh, is that you slipped and fell on some stairs on a day that was had cold precipitation? See, that's I'm always nervous around like wet surfaces or anything because I've injured myself pretty good slipping and falling on a wet surface before. I would say keep doing that size for now.
Thank you.
cool. Slow down, slow down. See if we can get it to evenly fall there. That's the best case. Then we'll just smooth all that out. Hopefully avoiding an air bubble. Here we go. At least it's going to collapse evenly. Well, we have 60 pieces now. Again. Well, this one didn't fully detach, so there we go. Okay, I think we're gonna be okay. Gotta figure out what I'm doing when that happens. Am I just pushing in too high? I'm not getting low enough on the pot and making that area thinner. I think I can get to about 75 to 80, but we'll see. I think that I can save that one. Thank you. it splatters everywhere. Here we go. I've lost count again. But I think we're approaching 70. Well, there's a Kiba. Gee, where is he? Hey, buddy. Come on. Come on. Come on. He's like, why don't you just move the thing? No. You bumped the camera, buddy. Here you go. What are you doing? And he missed it. He walked right around it. Shoo, buddy. I'm gonna move this before anything bad happens. Yes, catastrophe. From either of them. Kiba knocking it over or Minnie licking it. He's like, good, you're finally done. And we have 70. That was 70. I knew we were getting close. I'm going to take a hydration break. It's like a Kiba petting break too. Oh, same spot? Okay. He's like, just get that thing off of me. Getting clay on you is what I'm doing, buddy. Oh, you were doing a pretty good job of that yourself. Gotta make sure we have that 2% cat fluff in every piece. Guaranteed. It is quickly approaching treat time, and I think I'm being given a not so subtle hint. Maybe just a few more, okay? Just a few more. Come on. That's what he does to me when I'm typing on the keyboard. He'll sit there and bat at my fingers while I'm trying to type. Yeah, Purple's like, but Mom! Mm-hmm. Right? Meow! My Christmas sweater says Meowy Christmas. Because why not? Did I get him? I don't know if I splattered him with water or not. Give me a second. Your ugly Christmas sweater is a t-shirt that has the knit stitches screen printed on it, and it has Cthulhu, yes. Was that one okay? Was that one pass? Got my supervisor here. Lynn, hello. Good afternoon. Kiba here is supervising the process very, very closely. Slow tail wag is good. Is that good? This one passes. Oh. He's not getting his feet wet. Oh, whoop, nope. Too late. Really? You gonna go over there and knock over my empty water bottle? What would we do without him? I know. Come on. I know. Go ahead. Knock it over. It's empty. Make sure he wasn't sitting on the mouse. Can you fill that with tap water, please? Because his hind ass wants some water. Thank you. That was my fault. Come on. Come on. He's like, I'm all the way over here now. He's like, it's too far. I can't do it. Kiba. Spoiled rotten turd. Come on. It's like, that is not fresh water. Did you want down? Usually he climbs down by himself. It's like, no, I just want to sit here and be cuddled. What would we do without him? Be a little bit more productive, I think. There you go, buddy. More productive, but much less entertained, right? I'll accept a fuzzy middle management any day. They work for treats. And chin scratches. All right, I'll do one more. And that'll be 75, and that'll be a good stopping point. All right, we have 75 mugs. And these will be... With these, I'm trying to build up stock for our show that is in January. So tomorrow, I'll probably be putting these together and maybe prepping for some glaze. So we've got pieces in the bisque kiln right now. Banny, you saw me on Kick earlier. Yes. Well, we are multi-streaming, so we were in two places at the same time. Right now, I am looking on Twitch to find somebody to raid. That is amazing. I don't know who this is. Crochet Fry-yay cat sweater. Abra Katrina. Does anybody know them? They are crocheting what looks like an amazing cat sweater. I think we need to go see this thing. I think we all need to go see this thing. Let's go see what this is all about. I've lost my chat. There it is. Alright guys, thank you so much for watching. Thanks for hanging out with me for a little bit. We're gonna go see what this awesome cat sweater looks like, because it seems like it's gonna be pretty cool. And I will see y'all later. If I don't see you again, have a wonderful weekend. But thank you so much for hanging out with me for a little bit. and helping me get a little bit of work done, despite the cats. So let's go see this thing. Have a good night, guys.